Every day at 7 o'clock in the morning, several dozens of visitors gather in the reception center of the Volcanoes National Park in Kinigi, a little village in the north of Rwanda. They all come here to visit the mountain gorillas. Of the 900 mountain gorillas that are still living in the wild, 600 live in Rwanda. The others are living in the DRC and in Uganda. Nowadays, the security situation in Rwanda is very good, and the country became one of the best organized destinations in Africa. Just recently, the price of a ticket to visit the gorillas was doubled from $750 to $1,500 US. And a lot of people thought that this would scare off the gorilla tourists. But is this so? We followed a group of trekkers on the slopes of Sibinyo Volcano and recorded their findings, their feelings, and their thoughts.
On espérait trouver les gorilles ici, mais ils sont partis pour manger, donc on doit les suivre, ils sont chefs. Mais on a à tout prix besoin de les voir, et c'est pour cela qu'on décide de descendre.
Mais non, pour monter, c'était pas très facile. Mais maintenant, on glisse et ça, c'est très, très difficile.
Great huge climb to get here, but really a great adventure.
Pour être franche, on a hésité au départ parce qu'on a trouvé que c'était quand même très 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 cher. Mais une fois qu'on comprend où va l'argent et que ça va pour la conservation, pour l'agrandissement de la forêt, pour les gorilles, et que vraiment les gorilles sont protégées, je pense que ça vaut la peine. Et bien sûr aussi l'infrastructure pour arriver jusque-là est extraordinaire. Ça vaut la peine de le faire une fois dans la vie, même si c'est cher, c'est une expérience vraiment inoubliable et marquante, parce qu'on a vraiment l'impression de faire partie de leur famille.
Rwanda made a lot of progress after the war, and the country has now become very safe. The local population is also involved in the local tourism trade. Some of these porters were once poachers, and now they are helping the tourists to walk through the dense jungle. Everything is very well organized, and nothing is being forgotten. The Rwandan government is not hiding the fact that they are focusing on high-end tourists, and this is starting to pay off. Opening the park for mass tourism would be impossible anyway, and would put too much strain on the animals and the local environment. Inbound tourist agencies are therefore not panicking that the prices to see the gorillas have doubled. Compared to the surrounding countries, there is nearly no corruption in Rwanda, and most of the money the tourists are paying is being reinvested for future development.
So far, we are still getting more bookings, and in the world, we know that many people understand the importance of conservation, and we are sure that after a few years, everyone would have understand that importance, and the bookings will keep coming as they used to be before.
By increasing the price of gorilla trekking, the government also doubled the amount allocated to community activities, community projects that are happening around the area bordering.
For most of the tourists we talked to during and after their trek, paying 1,500 US is not an issue, because they understand that most of their money will be used to protect the animals and to stimulate the local economy. And the difficult walk uphill also adds to the value of this once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Well, maybe it's a cliche, but it really is a once-in-a-lifetime experience. Even if you go back, it is every time different. And today it was, they promised that it would be an easy walk, but it was actually a medium difficult walk. But still it was nice, and then you see the gorillas, and in fact you become part of the family. You're sitting close to them and you see them, the little ones playing and the old guys laying in their, on their silverback. And so, well, it reminded me of my own family a little bit.